Neo Nail Space, who's this? We'll go over this new nail space sometime soon because obviously you guys are noticing that I'm in a new setup. I am so happy to be in this new setup. This setup, it gives me life. But the reason why you're here today, the Zoya Summer 2020 Splash Collection. Let me show you these boxes. If you're with me on Instagram, which I recommend that you go there and follow me over there, selfless plug, you have seen that I received these as PR. It's 12 of them, so let's go through swatches and then we'll talk final thoughts, blah, blah, blah. I don't wanna take 3 years on the intro. I'm excited, you can tell by my energy level today, but that's it, let's go. Eclipse is a topper, you can also wear it by itself. I see that it has like a clear base with a bunch of glitters that seem to be iridescent. Super, super beautiful. It feels very romantic. Formula is good. It's thin. It's not one of those super thick toppers or anything. And it goes pretty well with a lot of the colors in the collection. Or if you wear it by itself, it gives you like a cute little shimmer that you don't have to worry about. It's one of those throw it on and go. Pretty cute topper. And I actually don't have anything else like this in my collection, so I was happy about it. Jody is a pink with lilac undertones. It was two coats for me. It's kind of white based, so the first coat is gonna be kind of streaky, but then it built up nicely on the second coat, so I really have no complaints about it. I don't have anything exactly like this in my collection, and Zoya has a thing for doing colors that appear like when you see it, you feel like, oh, I have a bunch of these, and then when you actually look, you don't. They just have a way of playing with undertones that really, you know, makes their colors unique. So that's Jody. Emma looks like a coral to me, but very peachy pink. Very, very cute. This is the type of color that makes your skin look kind of tan. At least it does that for me. It was two coats for opacity, and I liked it. I think it's pretty. I think it's gonna be cute for pedicures as well. Good, solid, you know, romantic, soft coral tone for summer. Leilani has a pink jelly base, and I don't know if it's just pink or like fuchsia, magenta-ish type of color. Not magenta, more fuchsia. And it has some gold micro glitters or shimmers in it. And let me tell you, this color, when I first saw it in the bottle, I didn't think I would like it. And the more I have worn this color and swatched it and done comparisons, I realized that I am surprisingly very, very drawn to this color. And I think it's because the glitters that it has just glisten like crazy. So this is gonna be perfect for like summer pool beach days or whenever you're out and the sun's gonna hit your nails. This is gonna be extremely fun. It was two coats for me for complete opacity. Very, very like impressed by this color. It has something special, I think. Sally has like a orange red jelly base with the same gold glitters that Leilani has. And for some reason, I mean, it was opaque for me in two coats. And for some reason, I didn't like it as much as Leilani. I don't feel like the shimmers glisten as much. And I don't know why that is. I don't know. I think they just contrast better in Leilani. If you like these types of polishes, very solid, you know, opaque into easy coats, great formula. I'm just not sure about it for me. Usually reds that have extreme orange undertones don't do much for me. I don't know, I just end up either picking a straight up orange or straight up red. I'm usually not in the middle, but very solid polish, opaque into coats. If you like shimmer, you might love this. Goretta, this was an extremely easy formula. It's a little bit on the thinner side than regular creams, so it wasn't a one coater because of that, but it was extremely even, very even. You guys are gonna see in the live swatch. First coat, perfect. It was just that I needed one more coat for opacity. But if you don't care about a little bit of nail line showing, this you can wear in one coat and be out. It dries beautifully. It's a seems to be like a classic red. I don't see many undertones in here. If anything, maybe a tiny, tiny, tiny little bit of orange somewhere in there, but it just feels really like summery red for me. I think this is a good one. I actually don't own any Zoya red, so I was excited when I saw this one in there. Christy, another fabulous formula, opaque in two coats, just a hot pink for summer. It's a good color if you don't have anything like this. This one doesn't feel as unique as that other coral that I was talking about, but it's just pretty solid if you don't have anything like this. And this is a color that you like, it'll be a good one. It's raining a lot outside. There's nothing I can do about that. If I'm gonna wait for all the environmental things to be in perfect unison for me to film, I might as well just close my YouTube channel because between my family being at home and Corona, and everything that's happening outside and just the weather, and it is what it is, guys. I'm sorry. You just think of it as ASMR. A little bit of rain in the background. Nature calls. Jessica is a purple. This is the only color that I think doesn't fit here. I don't know. I mean, I don't even know if it feels like summer color at all. Like, some purples feel like a summer purple. This one, I'm not sure, but it's a solid, you know, pretty purple. And actually, I have in my notes here that it took 3 coats for opacity. That's weird, because usually Zoya does purples like super awesome, barely need a second coat. And this one must be the jelly nature that it has. It needed 3 coats. So, solid color, needs 3 coats. I think Zoya has better ones. And this just happened. Yay, fun. Next up we have Marin. This was to pick for me in 2 coats. It's a beautiful blue. We have seen some blues from Zoya. You guys are gonna see on my Instagram if you're following me. I have some comparisons. It probably reminds you of Walker from last year's summer 2019 Barefoot collection. I have a comparison for that coming up in my Instagram, or maybe by the time this video goes live, I've already posted it, but keep your eyes peeled. It is not a duplicate. I don't have, you know, any other Zoya blue that's a duplicate of this in my collection. I'm sure there probably are out there, but I just don't have one. Good solid blue, feels summery, opaque in 2 coats, great solid polish. Harbor feels like either a turquoise, and I never know how to say this word, so please excuse me, or like a light green leaning teal. I don't know, it feels like an ocean type of color. It was opaque for me in 2 coats, and actually when I wore it, it did stain a little bit, just lightly, and I feel like a lot of these green pigmented colors will stain you a little bit. But I mean, it wasn't nothing epic, but I just, you know, when I took it off, I saw my nail and I was like, okay, write this down and let them know. If you're gonna wear it for a week, just double base coat on this one. Anytime you see something highly pigmented, just, and if you care about stains, which I personally don't, but if you care about stains, anytime you see something that's highly pigmented on the greens or purples, just be safe, double base coat, move on, enjoy the color, nothing happens. The stain goes away, so. But yeah, beautiful, solid, summery, oceany type of green. Next up we have Fisher, and this is a light blue jelly base with like a golden shimmer. I had to do 3 coats to make it opaque. In the bottle, it looks gorgeous. And when I actually put it on for a meet, it washed me out. That has happened to me this year with other colors that are similar. When the base is that bluey, kind of greenish jelly thing, and then there's a shimmer on top. The shimmer tends to be the same color as my skin, and something happens that is just not right for me. But you know, if you like this, it will be opaque in 3 coats. You can try and put it on top of something else where the, you know, another color that's similar to the base, and you might get a pretty shimmer. Felt a little bit short for me because it's so beautiful in the bottle. But when you actually apply, at least for my skin tone, it didn't really translate. But I mean, I'll leave that up to you guys. You can see in the swatch video, see the swatch picture, and see if it's something for you. It is definitely not for me. If you guys have been following me for a little bit, you know that in the past I've had issues with these types of colors on my skin. But maybe it works for you. If the swatch picture looks good and it's something that you think will work for you, just, it's a solid polish. It's just a jelly base, so you need 3 coats for opacity. That's about it. And the next one is Corina. This one was actually opaque for me in 2 coats, which is so weird. This is the exact same formula as Fisher, but this one was more opaque for me. I think it's very romantic. I think it's pretty. I like this one on my skin tone so, but it's so close. It is so close to my skin tone that I don't know. But if this tone of pink is something that you think will look good on you, it's a very solid polish, very, very pretty, very romantic. And I think if you pair this one up with Eclipse, you're gonna get like a beautiful romantic little princess type of look. It's really, really pretty. If I have to pick my favorite, I have to pick this one, the Leilani. A lot of the other colors in the collection, I just feel like I already have them. This is unique to my collection. It is memorable. I like the formula. It's opaque in 2 coats. It's glistening when you wear it. I'm gonna be wearing this summer, if I can get out of my house this summer at some point. My least favorite has to be, where are you, baby? This one. That's just personal. It looks gorgeous in the bottle, washes me out as crazy. I am probably never gonna wear this. Like I said, as far as the collection being coherent, being pretty, let me show you the boxes again so that you have memory of the colors together when you finish watching this video. They are gorgeous. The whole theme feels like a party in summer, you know, whether it's summery drinks, whether it's bathing suit colors, whether it's sunsets, beach, pool parties, you have it. Now, individually, like I mentioned, very few of the colors are unique, at least to my collection, at least compared to what I've been seeing this summer. The colors are solid, they're good colors, but I feel like we've seen them before. They seem to be standard primary type of colors. You know, you have the blue, you have the red, you have the typical tealish, you have the coral, you have pink, and your purple. So I'm usually very used to Zoya doing weird funky undertones, dusting things out, you know, bringing up combinations of tones and undertones that you're not used to. So this one feels very classic. That's the word I'm trying to look for. So I'm surprised about this because I usually say this, that Zoya has a way of giving undertones to colors. Like this one has a lilac undertone that feels like you have it, but you don't. And I'm used to Zoya doing this all the time. So seeing so many colors that are classic, I don't know, just it doesn't seem like Zoya to me. But like I said, as a whole, the collection is very, very pretty. And if any of these colors is something that interests you, you guys are gonna be happy. Let me know in the comments below which ones are your favorite. I don't know if you guys are gonna be picking anything from this collection up. If you are, let me know. I would like to like chat about it. Have a great day. Thank you guys for tuning in, and I'll see you next time. Bye.